这样子一个大的国际合作的画地图这样子一件事情的时候呢，通常都是要有一个非常蓬勃的在地的社群当做那个种子，让外面知道说，哎，他们需要什么。那这个种子的这个概念呢，其实呢就是咖喱咖喱，也就是我们的讲者会讨论的。那所以我想，因为时间也差不多了，所以就我们就开始这样子，就麻烦鼓个掌，谢谢。大家随时都可以在那个 slide 上面提出问题。
Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Rajiv Timar Sinha from Gali Gali, Nepal, and I'm going to talk about one open source digital platform for bridging the gap between citizen and local government in Nepal. Okay. So why we started this platform? So I'm just giving some context. For example, if I need to get a passport, right? Or I need to get a citizenship. So there's always confusion, what to do and where to go, or what type of documents should I have to produce. So if we go to offices or look some bureaucratic process, there is a process, there's a system, but still it is confusing, complex, and very difficult to follow the process. So in that context, we started Gali Gali. So today I'm going to talk about this, and for that I have just structure my presentation like this. First, I will try to give brief context of Kathmandu, where we are focusing. And then I will deal one slide about the internet culture in Nepal. And the third, my focus will be on introducing my organization, Gali Gali. Then I will focus entirely my presentation on our online platform that is called Nalivali, and why we build that platform, and also detail information about that platform, Nali Valley. And finally, I'll try to identify some challenges and some lessons, and what we are planning to like go ahead for like in future. So in this way, I will just wrap up my presentation. If we talk about whole Nepal and Kathmandu, it is fastest urbanizing country in South Asia. In last 5 years, our urbanizing rate is, I think, 114%. So most of the people, they are moving towards urban places, or our semi-urban villages are being more urbanized or converted into cities. And if you look the population of Kathmandu Valley, it was like 1.6 million in 2001. This is only registered population. In Nepal, it is very difficult to get real or the fact data. So this is only registered with government. And now in 2011, it reached 2.5 million. But in reality, we assume or we guess there are more than 5 million people in Kathmandu. And the government structure is so confusing. The for your information, in last 18 years, we don't have local election. Nepal is a republican, like democratic country, but we don't have election. We don't have like the local structure, the clear local structure. And that's why bureaucrats are running all the local government bodies. And it's so complicated, also confusing. These days, the youths are being so vocal, and they are also being techno-savvy, because in last 5 years, the internet culture in Nepal or the access to internet have been increasing rapidly, but the services is not. So there is one idea. Many people, this kind of youths or new generation, they have kind of one sense that they need rapid or radical reform in the system. So for that, they need large amount of money and also mass or kind of larger intervention. But we have started this organization from this another kind of thinking that we don't need always large amount of money or kind of larger intervention. We can also start to dent the system with limited resources or our small group. So based on that context, also if you look the internet culture in Nepal, we have like very low penetration rate. In 2011, it was 29%, 29.78% like internet users in Nepal, and the higher percentage of that is mobile phone. So many people, they use internet, GPRS internet in mobile phone, and most of the Nepali people are, they are only literate, or many of them, they can't use even the smartphones. And another problem is like, even they can use, but there are very less like sites or platform that is in Nepali. Most of the like the data, they are available in English, which people can't read, can't understand, and can't use. So now almost half of the population has access to internet, and that was relative double in compared to 2001. So in this context, like we have started Gully Gully. So I'm going to introduce what is Gully Gully. So Gully Gully is a hybrid organization. Many people like in Nepal also or throughout the globe, people focus on NGO. They try to like start NGO, which are mostly like rely on grants. And sometimes like, there are a lot of work done by private companies. So this organization is hybrid. It mixes both. So we establish this company. Now we can make profit. We can do business also, but we cannot distribute profit. So we have to work as a NGO also. So it's a hybrid, so it is non-profit distributing, profit not distributing company, on working to strengthen citizen-state relationship in Nepal. So our focusing area is three. The first one, we focus on dialogue. We bring some government officials or kind of people from service providing side, and we also bring citizens or local people or other like service recipients, and we hold monthly discussions. We broadcast that online, also through local stations, radio stations, and other means by using technology or media. And second one, like we are working on online platform, which I am going to talk today about this platform. And that gather and package and disseminate the information on government or government services. And third one, we also work on the ground or offline. We mobilize volunteers. And if some people look our website, and still they find confusing, they want someone to help them, then they ask us. If they ask us, we send our volunteers to support them in the office. So in this way, we are also supporting people if they require assistance. So now I'm going to talk about this online platform, which is like the crucial digital platform we have developed in Nepal. The main focus of this nalibeli.org. So this the open data platform. This highly, it has the Nepali pages. Also, we have some English translated pages, but we have very limited pages in English because our focus is on the Nepali youth, so they can use in it is in Nepali. So we have some belief like we have failed a lot of time. So last time we tried to develop this platform by using the Wikimedia or Wikipedia that database, but many Nepali people they didn't like to use this. So we have a lot of problem because they didn't like to use it frequently. Now we have redesigned this platform. And now we have hosted this. Like now we have started since September in a new design. Still there, it is not that much like user friendly. We are still working to modify by learning lessons from our work. And still there is no guarantee that any kind of intervention will succeed absolutely. So we are learning, we are trying to making life easier. We are also modifying our work so that we can help the people. So Nalibeli is an initiative that gathers, packages, and disseminates information. So it gathers information, it also put in the platform, and also it spread or it like distributes information through online, also through offline, through the volunteers. It is crowdsourced information, and also any people, they can look, make, or edit, move the pages in this platform. So we have both versions in Nalibeli. we have built this because we see the value of dialogue. Here, like, people can not only can use the data, they also can contribute the data. They can contribute from their side. Also, it helps the participatory decision-making process. Also, it is both like top-down and bottom-up information flow process, and there is like high potentiality for the larger flow of information. So, we have two versions of pages. One is English. To reach the English page, we have type like www.nalivale.org/English, ENG. And for the Nepali version, we have like www.nalivale.org. So, we have more than 1,000 pages right now in this both sites. So how we gather information? That's like, for that questions, like, we have three kind of system. One, we have volunteers or interns. They go to government offices or public offices. They talk with the service providers and they list down the services and they create the pages. Second one, if people have any problem, we have mechanism that they can call us, they can email us, or they can send messages through Facebook or other social sites so that we can find answer for them. Now we not only give answer to them, we also build some pages and we put that into our website so that other people can also use that site. And third one is like, if sometimes the government offices themselves approach us to make some online sites or some kind of knowledge or pages to spread their information. So these are three ways we are building the sites and we are providing supporting people here. So after, like, since September, we have redesigned and we have launched the new website, new platform. Now we have more than 200 contributors. That's like, we think it's a large number in case of Nepal, because very few people, they like to contribute or they like to edit the pages. And also, like, according to Google Analytics, we have 15,417 pages views from, like, since 2015 December. So we have now more than 1,000 pages in this website. So we have covered diverse offices. It means we are not focusing only on education. We have, like, now about, like, educations, like university. Now we have, like, pages about the local municipality. We have, like, pages about the passport office. So we have, like, trying to focus multiple offices, government offices, and we are, like, at least providing information about location, where we can get services, and how much time it requires, and how much you have to pay for that, and what type of form, how you can fill that form, and what is the process. Here is very interesting. Like, in the government offices, like, they also have some kind of citizen charter, but they have formal Nepali language. Even I can't understand sometimes those, like, formal Nepali words. So we are trying to write that in very simple language, because in Nepal, there are more than 125 ethnic groups and more than 126 different languages. Many people, they can't understand Nepali properly, even let alone the English. So many offices, they have sites in English, either in Nepali, but not in other native languages. So we are trying to at least, like, make the simpler Nepali so that other non-native people who has little Nepali knowledge also can understand it in their own, like, kind of informal language. So that is very challenge for us. So our attempt is, like, to make transparent the information which are hidden. And also we want to make the information easy to use for those people. And the third one is to make it more dynamic so that we are not only sharing, people are not only, like, using this, they also can share. So we know that Nepali officials, they are so corrupt. Sometimes they also charge bribes or some money to get some services. Now we started to, like, have some discussion board where even people can share not only legal process, also they can share some practical process, how they can get their work done very, like, quickly or easily, so that other people can get help. So this is, like, but later, like, many government officials, they show their kind of unsupport or non-cooperation because we are focusing on these de facto processes, and that will show their weakness. So now we are trying to, like, find some kind of middle way, how we can at least help people, also not, like, worsening the relationship between bureaucrats and the people also. So Now we have some challenges, like we are facing some kind of obstacles in this process as well. So first one is people, they want to like answer or they want to know about a lot of processes. They want to know about, they want to use the information, but they don't want to contribute. How to tackle it like with? Maybe it is also because of language issue. Many people, they can't read Nepali, but it's so difficult to type in Nepali in computer. That is not like Nepali language friendly devices. And also like it challenges for us to increase the growth, like grow to increase the page views. So maybe because of like people, they are Nepali people, according to survey, the most used site is Facebook. And second one is there is some kind of YouTube and some other video or kind of which sites they have some kind of drama, teleserial or films. So even Twitters they rarely use, and only journalists use Twitters in Nepal, and this type of information they feel very uncomfortable to use because these are kind of like heavy reading, like a lot of like processes and or text. So this is also one challenge for us to increase the frequent participation, because people once bit, one visit the pages, this very like less repetition of the like visiting pages. And also for us, like it is challenge to make it more user friendly, because people, I already said, people are used to with Facebook and social sites. They don't prefer this kind of websites which provide a lot of like information. So we have some like lessons already identified because of these kind of challenges. The first one is social media is so popular. That's why we have to at least modify our platform, or we have to integrate this platform with social media like Facebook so that people can use it more in Facebook or other app. And also we have to like focus more on highlighting indexing system over search. That's why even if you type few words in English, you can get Nepali pages, because in Nepali it's so difficult to type in Unicode. So we have to like type in Unicode. There's even no like Nepali language in inputting keyboards available in market. So also we have to like change the inputting method, trying to make it more simple so that people can input to search the data, also to contribute. And also we have to focus on more outreach, because we have developed this because of the media access. Maybe many people, they don't know about this. So other challenge for us is to like increase our visibility among our users. So at least we believe that we are trying to bridge service provider, state and the citizen. Also, we are creating some open data, and we are also trying to make aware people about the urban, social and development issues through the discussions and through the information disseminations. And we are contributing for the accountability in the country, because there is very less like check and balance system in Nepal, because there is no government. Even if the bureaucrats are running it, there is no kind of civil society accountability system where people can track the services and also discuss about this. And we are also trying to empower people by providing information. We believe in democracy. If you have access to information, if you know the process, it will empower people. They can be confident to get services. So our next step is we are planning to redesign Nali Valley to make it more user friendly. Just coming here, I had one like meeting with Search for Common Ground. They have like very popular Nepali teleserial drama that is called Singha Darbar, that is about all this politics and the governance system in Nepal. Now they have requested us to develop one app which can like compile all those YouTube channels in our app. So now we are going to integrate this with our Nali Valley, this platform, so that our like information will go side by side with the drama teleserial portal. So we'll have one app that can be used in smartphones. At the same time, you have the list of drama, and if you have any problem, you can ask question, so that will link to our website, so people can use it in more like user-friendly way. We are planning for that, focusing more on aesthetics, indexing, also very easy to navigate, and new kind of inputting system where people can input very easily. Also, it will be integrated in social media. People can share some like, maybe we can create some kind of memes or some kind of like games or some kind of like cartoons which can be shared in Facebook or some kind of social media where people like to use this. So we'll target also, we'll try to meet with media people, journalists, and other civil society people to increase the visibility of our this platform so that it can be used by the people. And that's why at last, like, we have some hope. In next 2 years, we have set some goals. Like, the first one, we are planning to have over 100,000 like active user database or user base for our platform. And also we hope that we will have dynamic conversation and community on social media. So we'll build some kind of like that app where people can be engaged in discussions and like some question answers, or kind of that will engage people lively with our platform. And also we are like planning to do some kind of intervention, not only online platform, also in offline. We are focusing, or we are thinking to like have some kind of interventions based on the research or based on our first-hand experiences in the government offices by our volunteers. And more than that, we want to be self-sufficient, so that we have started consulting services side by side. If like our information is free, you can use this free of cost. If you want volunteers, if you ask us, we provide volunteers also. At the same time, we have provided like consulting service where there are some business houses or some companies, they want like help from us to renew their offices or their license or to get some other services. If they are ready to pay, if they also can ask us like for the consulting service, so that we'll provide some professional our staff, they will go, they will provide services, and from that we'll get some money as a fee, and that money will be used for this platform. So we are doing certain businesses, also we are supporting for this noble cause. So this is kind of rough figure of Kathmandu City made by our intern to put in our platform. It's a city of flying tempo, because we don't have mass transit system in Kathmandu. We have very small tempos and small like microbus, so even transportation is so complicated. So we are also planning to like focus more on this open street map and making life easier. But still, we have tried, but still we need, I think, a lot of support to go to that part. That's it. Thank you.
Wow, it was great. So time for questions. So there's actually a lot of questions, and so keep the answers brief and to the point. So our first question is that your target audience, that you say you require very simple language, less mile presence, offline door-to-door, and also Facebook. So are existing open tools already supportive of your needs, or do you have to rewrite most things? 即使说他们现在这样子，就是说一大半人其实还没有上网，然后在这样子，即使上网可能也只用脸书这种状态的时候，现有的开源的软体对这个是支持的吗？还是其实他们什么都得从头写起？
Okay, it's very important questions. In case of Nepal, like, we have some kind of existing open source tools, but they are not supportive because of like two reasons. One, people like, if they have, they need to like go for some services, they generally they go to the agents. Well, they charge some money and they provide services. There, you can find like more than hundreds of agents sitting in front of government offices. So you go directly to offices, you first meet those agents, and they charge some kind of money. Also, they fix the corruption rates for the government officials, and they get services. And that's why, like, second one is also a lot of like these existing open source tools, they are in English. Or if in Nepali also, people have, they can't access it properly because of the complication of this language. Also because of like power cuts. In Nepal, we have more than 12 hours power cuts in a day. So our internet doesn't like work properly. Like even in the day, sometimes you have to wait for many hours to get your works done through online media. So using online platform is also sometimes very difficult because you don't have any power to even charge your mobile. There's a lot of like obstacles to use those like existing open source tools, I think.
对，所以我们写程式的时候，很多觉得说网络一定不会断哈，那他们在这种状况底下是需要自己做很多调整。那下一个问题是说，尼泊尔其实有16个不同的地方语言。那在这样的情况之下 ，so do your government already promotes cross language studying so that people speak like one or two or three common languages in their study, or if the government is not doing it, are you trying to do it because it seems like the most important website? 所以他们有自己要做多语言教育或者跟政府合作吗？
The government just after like the 2007 revolution, government has recognized that we have the like more than one languages in Nepal. So this is only one attempt. And now, from last 5 years, some of the primary schools they are offering educations in multiple languages. But still, we don't have that kind of expertise to provide multiple languages across languages system. Last year, we tried to like visit some of those areas where the different language is spoken. We tried to meet some college students. Now we are thinking to mobilize those students as contributing users for our platform so that they themselves can edit our page, then create a page in their language. So rather, we are doing this. Now we are focusing, maybe we'll focus next 2 years to translate these Nepali pages into their own native language, because for us, it will cost too much. We can't do like to translate one page into more than 70, 80, or 90 working language. So I think we have to find those like volunteer Nepali youths who are still in college life, so that they can support their community if they have sense that they want to support their family or their background, their community by doing this service. I think we have to create those type of pool to support them.
Okay, so I think you already answered this, yeah. Right? Yeah. Okay. So, 因为下一个就是问题是说关于就是不是讲尼泊尔语的，那就是有没有 outreach program？ 那他刚刚已经回答了，所以我们就接下来。So, did the government actually use your feedback to focus on infrastructure people need？ 政府真的有是不是有用他们这边所拿到的数据来知道说要改变哪些道路啊，或者水啊，或者是交通耗制或电力吗
？In this question, yeah. The government is trying to also use our suggestions or feedbacks. The first, I can give like 2-3 examples. The first one, Kathmandu Metropolitan City themselves, they have requested us last month to provide our volunteers to like support them, because they have started this vital registration system in online from last month. So they want our volunteers not only like inform about that system through our this platform, also provide our volunteers to support government staffs, because even government staffs, they can't use online like or internet properly. So they asked from volunteers from us. So our volunteers now there sitting with the government officials and supporting not only government officials, they are also learning the working environment there. And second one of the chair of parliamentary committee for women development and children, he is like very interested to work with us, and then he has like already visited our office, and also the chief secretary of the Nepal government also he paid visit to our office, and now they have started some kind of like some movements in Kathmandu for the waste management and for other kind of like services, like to making aware not only like through the civil society, also even the chief secretaries and other army officials, the police, they are themselves coming to the like streets with the local civilian people, and every Saturday, so that is a weekend, they are just like coming with some kind of brush, and they are trying to clean the river, they are cleaning kind of dust. I think this kind of great message like they are giving in the last few months, which is like showing that they are also listening the people's suggestions about this.
So do you work with any paper media or TV, like traditional media? 他们跟就是一般的主流媒体有合作吗？
Yeah, there are some national dailies and medias. They have like covered a lot of news about us. Even we have like some monthly discussions, and the journalists, they come to like visit, even in the discussion, they take part in discussion also, they publish it about it in their sites. Last like 2 months back, there was one national media that covered whole half phase like about our Nalibili platform. After that, like within 1 day, there was more than 15,000 hits in our page. Mm. So that shows like one kind of like in efforts so that now we are planning to go more media coverage in next like few months. Yeah.
Okay. So the next just this part.
Okay. Like,
所以其实下一个问题是说有 Open Data Portal 嘛，就是像就是 data.gov 或这类的东西。那因为他问的人是说，在韩国的时候，其实这个东西大部分是韩国政府自己提供的。那在尼泊尔，就是你们有做 Open Data， 所以 you have worked on Open Data， but this is a national initiative that you happen to work with， or are you leading the initiative？
In Nepal, like government, I think it has established the information department where they are more focusing on RTI, right to information. Now, I heard the news like last month, they have one provision that every offices of government offices, they should fix one person official as a information official with his photo, his name, and his phone number. And that should be like posted in front of the office gate so that people can see who is the information officer in that office. If they have any problem, they can call to that office and also get some information. But I don't know how much it will like practically like be used, because in Nepal, like in last 20 years, we have seen there are many promises from government, but nothing works, because even there is no like government exists in local bodies. There are more than 4,000 local bodies, but no government, like no one elected body is there. So I don't like believe that this will work, because those bureaucrats, they are getting some money from the agents by not providing information, because people go to agents and they pay for the information. So I think they will really open up for this. By words, they are saying they are promoting open data, but by practice, they want to like don't want to open themselves that much up, because they will lose their extra earnings.
所以这个要先做资讯公开，才能做开放资料哈。So the last question: did any of your volunteers also work on the earthquake and the recovery crisis management?
Yeah, our volunteers, like even we were so busy like after the earthquake for last like 3 or 4 months. Actually, we were very busy in social audit of after the earthquake relief distribution. So most of our volunteers, we divided 3 teams for the main 3 reasons, and where they helped the government officials to gather data, and at the same time, they were auditing whether the real victims are getting relief or not, or how much that was like distributed to the real victims. So there are a lot of things. Just like we published that audit in hard copy last month, we don't have right now that online version, but at least we have published that hard copy and we have submitted to government offices and other like our partner organization who are involved with that. And one last information is that we have now more than 10 or 12 organizations, NGOs in Kathmandu. They are working for open data. Like there are Kathmandu Living Lab, Open Data Nepal. There are a lot of organizations. And from next month, they are coming in our neighbor. So now we'll be at the same venue, same office. There will be more than 10 or 11 offices. They are working for open data. And I think that will also help us for work combinedly for the common goal.
So truly great and inspiring work, 非常了不起的工作，请再次这个给一个掌声，谢谢。